Court, come to order.
Ms. Tisdale, would you stand, please? Your attorney tells me you would like for me to sentence you under the First Offender Act. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you personally asking me to do that?
Yes, please.
Do you understand that that act has some good parts and some not so good parts?
Yes.
The good part of the act is that if I sentence you under the First Offender Act and you successfully complete all of the terms of your sentence, you will not have a record. You will not have a conviction for this misdemeanor. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
The not so good part is that if you violate any of the terms of the sentence, you can be brought before the court, you would be adjudicated guilty of obstruction of officer, and you could be sentenced, basically resentenced at that time, up to the maximum that was remaining on your sentence, and you could be sentenced to jail for that time. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
So you're asking that I sentence you under the First Offender Act? I will agree to sentence you under the First Offender Act since you have requested it, so I will not adjudicate you guilty, but as to count two, obstruction of officer, I sentence you to the following. I sentence you to 12 months in the Dawson County Jail to be served on probation. You will have a $1,000 fine plus add-ons required by law. You will report to misdemeanor probation, and you will pay a monthly probation fee. You will perform 40 hours of community service work as directed by probation. You are to have no contact with Tony Wooten, and you are not to go on the premises of Burt's Pumpkin Farm. You will have all the other regular conditions of probation. I am not ordering that you submit any letter of apology. Law enforcement officers do not ask for letters of apology. They are doing their job. They get spat upon, they get attacked, they get shot, they get threatened, and that is part of their job. They don't ask for apologies or thanks. It's all in a day's work for them. Without law enforcement officers, our First Amendment rights, our property rights, any of our rights would mean nothing. That is the sentence. Is there any clarification that anyone needs? Mr. Greer?
No, Judge. Thank you.
Mr. Harvey?
I don't need any clarification.
All right. Who does the sentence? You all will wait. The sentence will be signed. I do have to inform you, Ms. Tisdale, you have been convicted by a jury. You have now been sentenced. You have a right to appeal your conviction to a higher court. You also have a right to file a motion for new trial with this court. You must do so within 30 days because the sentence will be entered today. I'm sure that Mr. Harvey will inform you of that right. And if the motion for new trial is denied, you would have 30 days from that point to file a notice of appeal. If you have any complaints about your attorney or the way your case was handled, you also would need to bring that to the attention of the court. You may be seated.